I felt like if I kept rooting through the campsite, someone would walk in on me. No, no. Don't look. No, no. Well, now I want to look. The grimy sink had a small patch in it that looked almost clean. A musty wooden plank propped open the stall door. It really didn't seem useful. Did I bother to take it? Yeah. Wasn't sure why, but I took the plank. Never know when you're gonna need to hit someone with a plank. You know, good old sturdy plank. Not sturdy plank to have. And don't know. Just don't know. Right, this was that campsite. So let's try that other patch of bushes. Where did this lead? The sign was the same as the first one I had seen. This must be the exit to the other side of the woods. If I'd finally found the exit, once I left, I knew I never wanted to return here. Let's leave! Finding the campsite had been strangely unsettling. I couldn't imagine why anyone would abandon their site in the middle of the night, especially in that dark forest. I was relieved to be, at least, to be finally out of there. Even now, as I peered through the dense trees, I could see cracks of light in a bit of the land beyond. I must have been getting closer to town, but where was I exactly? I gotta say, this is very, very stable experience. As I stepped through the gate, I suddenly recognized the auto parts factory where I had worked as a machinist for all those years. The plant had closed almost 3 years ago now. Times were better then. I thought I could hear the faint rustling behind me. Maybe it was just the wind. Let's go into the factory, right? This sounds like a good plan. I heard something. Did other people hear it? One of the lockers hung open. Its contents were tossed around like someone had been looking for something. Did you guys listening hear something? There was a large power box with 5 lights on it. Cables burst out of the box, snaking off to other parts of the factory. Metal was starting to wear, and cobwebs had collected on the corners. This box wasn't receiving power. The door was locked shut. There was a little electronic box under the handle. A sign was pasted to the front saying, "Danger, closed for repairs." Seemed to be connected to the power box beside it. Door was closed. Going up them stairs. Every part of this plant smelled old and rotted. I noticed that the old bulletin board on the wall. The board contained yellowed clippings of newspaper cartoons and notices. There were notes to and from the guys that worked here. One of them was to Norman, who was one of the older guys on the line. Looks like a power panel. It looked like it was shut off. Did I push the switch? Yeah, of course. The open locker was stuffed with dirty work clothes and old boots. There was a photo of a woman taped on the inside, but it was scratched out like the face was unrecognizable. A power panel. Looked like it was shut off. Did I push the switch? Alright, that sounded like it kicked on. Okay, that's on. Cool. Cool. Shut tight. There was a rusty looking card slot on the side. So I need a key card. Awesome. Okie dokie. Our old break table, the layer of dust and grime only made seeing this more strange. Oddly, a very soothing, if off-putting game. The door had been hastily boarded up. Alright. This was Norman's locker. The door was dented like someone had punched it. I don't remember him doing that when he worked there. Another panel I had hoped could help me get the power back on. Did I push the switch? That kicked it on. Utility shelf, crammed with mismatched tools and items. There was a claw hammer on the shelf. Did I take the hammer? As I took the hammer, I noticed it wasn't as dusty as the rest of the tools on the shelf. I imagine I'm gonna need that later. Locker was a complete mess. Hidden at the bottom, though, was a magnetic card. Did I take the card? Yes. Slipped the key card into my pocket. Another panel that I hoped would get the power back on. Did I push the switch? Still wasn't working. Did I try it again? Still wasn't working. Did I try it again? Yep, there we go. Another panel that I'd hope would get the power back. Yep. Nope, didn't work. We're gonna try that again. There we go. All the power is on. All the power. All of it. Alright, the hammer let me pry open that boarded area. This was my locker there in the factory. Stank of booze. There's a picture of Rachel inside. Rachel. It looked like it had been torn up. I thought I'd taken that picture home when the factory closed. The floor was littered with old liquor bottles. Wondered if that man in the house had something to do with this. He sure had a lot of alcohol at his place. Huh. I get the feeling I'm drunk. I'm a drunk old man. The power box looked like it was running again. With the power box working, the door was unlocked. Didn't want to go through. I decided to try another way instead. Blackout drunk every day! The door opened now that the power was back on. Yeah, I'm sure something was going on. Rusty old regulator of some kind sat, dusty, unused against the wall. Planks, tools, and broken up parts blocked the way any further. That's interesting. Another smudge of dirt, similar to the one where I found in the sewers, was on the floor. Large pile of building materials and debris blocked the way on this path. What was that noise? The noise was very unsettling. Don't like this. A rack of flashlights hung on the wall. One of them was missing. Would it be mine? What's on the other side of that wall? I don't know. I want to know. My head pounded as I stepped back outside, once again enveloped in the scent of pine trees and muck. The path beyond was terribly dark, and I was grateful that my flashlight was still working. Wondered, though, was it taken from the plant? Sure seemed to, but how did I get a hold of it? I had little choice but to follow the path. And hope that it got me back to town. I wondered, Norman, had this store, his store along the main road, was he close? If he was, I was certain he could actually use some help. Yeah, this is a game that involves a lot of reading. That's a truck. Pickup truck had smashed into the guardrail and stood silent. Was this the truck that... Blah! Was this the truck that those newspaper clippings mentioned? Was there really a body to be found here, too? I looked closer at the tailgate, could see a series of dried streaks down its back. Inside the truck was dried blood and broken glass. I was surprised this hadn't been towed away yet. Read me a night-night story, sweet prince. Oh, I'll try. Gonna walk through this fence. You know what? Can I go back? There was a whole area I didn't explore, and I want to explore it. I want to explore that area that my weird key unlocked. I just kept pressing forward, and I never thought to go back. The factory door locked itself behind me. I can't go back. Looks like, in order to find out the secret of that area, I'll have to play this again. Alright. That's a gate. I'm gonna keep on moving. Another door. Hey! A garbage bin was a disgusting mess of rotten food and slick black bags. I saw a thin greenish corner poking out from one of the bags. It was my driver's license. It looked damaged. Did I take it back? Yes, I did. Cleaned the cart off as best I could and looked it. It looked pretty beat up. I was amazed to have found my credit card and now this. I tucked the card into my wallet and next to my credit card. Sounded like it was going to start raining again. Let's go inside this building. And entered Norman's place. This was the back of the store that he ran. It was oddly quiet except for the faint sound of television. Alright. So, this is Norman's. You get the distinct feeling that this person had tried to remove all evidence that they committed a murder and they were who they said they or who they didn't want to be anymore, and then tried to commit amnesia. And as an org, I would try that, but everyone would be able to hear your stream. I'm gonna open this here door here, see what's going on. What the hell? One of Rachel's old autumn coats hung on a rack. That was Norman's bedroom, wasn't it? What was this doing there? There was a well-maintained gun cabinet in Norman's room. I didn't know much about guns, but it looked like he kept a few hunting rifles. Why did it look open? Oh, that's blood. More blood. What is this? It looked like a pull chain hanging from the ceiling. Wonder where it could lead. Pull the chain? And it gave the chain a single tug, and a simple folding ladder popped down from the attic. TV still flickering on some indecipherable channel. Oh, hey! Oh, no. Couldn't believe what I'm seeing. Norman, my coworker and one of the few friends I had in this town, lay dead in his armchair. His face and shirt were covered in blood. It looked like he had been killed trying to get up. His eyes were still wide with shock. Norman, what was Rachel doing here? Why did you have her coat? Norman, maybe you deserved better. You probably did. Did I close his eyes? I closed his eyelids. I wasn't sure if I wanted to give him peace or if I just couldn't stand to think any more on what was going on. Well, it looks like we should go into the attic. Well, that's... There was a large cardboard box that hadn't been sealed. Did I open it? I opened up the old cardboard box and wasn't entirely surprised by what I saw, but there were more of Rachel things. More of my wife's clothes. Photos, shoes, even that old radio I gave her. Why, Rachel? What were you doing here with Norman? Oh, I think I know what happened. I hope I'm wrong. I hope this game is more clever than that. I guess this was Norman's kitchen table. He kept it clean enough. But there were water rings for two cups still in the wood. The kitchen trash bin smelled fresh. I didn't dig through that mess, did I? Yes, I did. I found a hairpin amongst the rotting food and trash and pocketed it. Why not? I'm a kleptomaniac, apparently. I went from being, gross thing.